Our attention today is still at the border, Thai-Cambodian border, after the World Court has come now with the verdict, which I believe is being closely studied and analyzed by both the Cambodians and the Thais, especially the governments of Hun Sen and the caretaker government of Apisit Wechachiwa.
And also the media.
Of course, the media.
There are a few interpretations in the media today.
Yes. Well, yeah, when they look at this map that the World Court has come up with, called the DMZ,
yes,
the Provisional Demilitarized Zone, a lot of people immediately say, hey, are we losing some of our territory or not? Which, in fact, it is just a DMZ map.
Yes.
You know, like in, if you have been to Seoul, the South and North Korea, both sides have to be included in the zone, otherwise...
Yes, you have to start somewhere, because the court ordered the Thailand and Cambodia to withdraw the troops.
That's right.
So how far the,
that's right,
the troops to be withdrawn has to be set by the court. So this is, in fact, just a demilitarized zone ordered by the court, not demarcation line.
No, in fact, the World Court has no authority to rule on the demarcation of borders anyway.
Right.
So this is practically... what the World Court is telling both Cambodia and Thailand, that you withdraw your troops out of this little square.
Yes, and after activities, the tourists can still go there. Other people you used to plant some trees in the area, you can still do that. You can fly flags, actually, except that military operations are prohibited in that area.
Well, Khun Apisit has commented on that after his meeting this morning with security officials. What is his stand now?
He took a little step back from yesterday.
Yep.
Yesterday it seemed that the Thailand, the Thai government was quite satisfied by the court order. But today he took a little step back and saying that the Thai government would not withdraw immediately from the area, and the Thai government, we have to wait for the for the Cambodian side to sit down and talk it out.
So it's back to bilateral talks again.
Yes, yes, of course.
The Cambodia was trying to drag the issue all the way up to the UN, hoping that there would be an international fuel that would force Thailand to do something that Cambodia cannot force Thailand to do bilaterally.
Right.
Now the whole thing has been thrown back by the World Court and say, Thailand and Cambodia, you better work it out. We want you to withdraw out of the DMZ and get let ASEAN come in and send the observers, and Indonesia will be the mediator.
Yes.
Back to square one.
Back to square one, absolutely. And it back to the border officials of the two countries, basically, to start, because it's naturally neither side would want to start first.
No.
So they have to sit down and talk and then do it together.
Yes. Well, when the World Court said immediately the withdrawal of troops, I don't think the World Court meant within 24 hours.
Right, but there's something about Thailand here, because we are in the transition. We are having a new government. And this the court order is up to the interpretation whether it's some kind of international treaty or order or obligation which has to be approved by Parliament.
Parliament.
According
and the
to
new Parliament hasn't been installed yet.
That's right. So if you talk about having the Senate take care of this, but the law said Parliament.
Parliament means so both house, the House and the Senate.
So no one has come out to comment on this in particular, but we believe that we should wait for the new Parliament to be in place. I mean the new House of Representatives.
I have been asked what would happen if Thailand and Cambodia, or Thailand or Cambodia, refuses to follow the World Court's order. Not pulling out. We are not going anywhere. We're going to stay
It would be difficult for the Cambodia to do that, because they are the one who raised the issue with the court. So the ruling come out, they have to follow it. It could be a little easier for the Thai side, because we are not the one who submitted the petition to the court in the first place. So we, but the government, the Thai government, has already stated its intention to to comply with the court.
Intention to comply,
but
when
how
nobody knows.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. So we're going to wait and see, and to find out. I think it could sort of take a few weeks because the new parliament in Thailand would not be officiated until early next month, I think.
Yes.
And then the new government has to be appointed before anything can happen. So Cambodia, we have to wait. And the World Court, we have to wait as well.